Can we try to do an interview? Tao, it would be nice if you just kind of, if I do have some video of you saying your name and introducing the exhibition, and then Taku can do more in depth.
All right, so just like kind of
a very general.
Thank you.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah, he has to open it just like that. And then walk this way. Now do it, like walk forward and go over the door. Yeah.
Walk out and just come out here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Should we rehearse?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Yeah, let's take this one.
Overstappen op lijn 10, 14, 17. Streek
no, now it's not working
it's
still.
Not working, right?
No, no, not yet. We have to wait to stop. And then should I make it brighter?
Change it with
so,
this work.
Elisabeth Wolfstraat.
Now I have to. I can talk. Are you filming?
Yeah, sure.
No, I have to wait for the thing to for the tram to stop, and then I can calibrate it zero movement. And then so now it will have to go to zero first. Let's hope the tram doesn't move before. Okay, now maybe we're fine. Yeah. Right. I haven't calibrated yet. Need some time of being still.
Wilner Dijkstraat. Overstappen op lijn 3, 12, 14.
Thank you.
some time to.
Oh, I see.
No, just film.
Westermarkt.
Just make a complete sentence.
All right, yeah, if I yeah, I just do the whole thing. So my name is Tao Gieberholt Sambolet, and I'm gonna talk about my project City Velocities Body Speed. It is a mixed media installation that that I've done at the residency here at Nink, Stein, and Sonic Acts for the Sonic Acts Traveling Time exhibition in 2012. And the title of the installation is City Velocities Body Speed, and it is about the dimension of speed that we inhabit as humans with our bodies while in public transportation at this instance. Yes.
Can you tell me how you realized this project, the process of building the installation? What are the elements that construct the installation?
Right. The installation consists is structured technically out of three entities. So one entity are velocity meters that are installed on several trams in Amsterdam that are actually measuring the speed of the of each tram on which they are installed, and sending the data, so this measured speed, to via a 3G network to the second entity of the installation, which is the receiving server, which receives this data, and then this server in turn controls the corresponding number of fans which blow the speed, which blow the wind with the speed of the speeds of the trams that they receive. So basically you have several speed meters and several fans. Each fan in the exhibition space represents or embodies the speed of one moving tram. So if the tram travels with the speed of 30 kilometers per hour, then this fan will blow the wind with the speed of 30 kilometers per hour in the exhibition space. So there is the element of the trams that are out in the city, and there is the exhibition space with now five ventilators which are embodying these speeds of five trams.
Can you tell me a little bit about the conceptualization that you work with of the inside and the outside?
Well, I mean, I was interested with or intrigued, or had a revelation one day that actually a lot of time we are in transport, in the urban situation especially, we are in transport, in motorized transport, and we find ourselves in a very ambiguous situation because we are sitting or standing still, but at the same time our bodies are moving. So, it's you sit and then you are somewhere else in 5 minutes, or 10 minutes, and that's quite strange actually, if you think about it from this perspective. And because of this public transportation, which is kind of nowadays so advanced, it's also the experience of the speed with which we are traveling is kind of minimized to slight, you know, tilts, jerks, and stuff like this. But we don't really, like, you know, experience it, and therefore are maybe not so aware of it, and therefore we are not maybe so aware of the relations between, like, movement, time, and energy, actually, which is all going on. So with this work, I was I wanted to bring attention to the dimension of speed in its purest form, which I could think of, which would be like on experiential level, kind of the movement of air, basically, because this is how we experience speed when we move. Like, it's the, you know, we go through air. Air is not nothing. Air is, like, you know, it is something, and we cut through it, and that's how we perceive it or experience it. So I was thinking if I could kind of extract only the speeds of these different trams in this instance, and kind of, you know, embody them in the exhibition space, so one could have the experience of those speeds that usually one doesn't have. So bring this to attention.
So you have a background in music as well,
right?
You know, in music you have structures, composition, and you also have sort of sounds as your medium or your material.
Right.
Can you tell me what this piece, does it relate to any sort of musical concepts or ideas of composition?
Well, I mean, I was thinking a lot about this, and I would say, since the structure of piece, since the time structure of piece is not, I mean, I'm not in control of it, it's basically just monitoring, you know, or like the reality out there, or like a part, a very specific, very particular kind of part of something that is not, that I don't control in this instance, like the tram traffic. So I don't really see it as a composition, I see it more like as a system that kind of that listens. It's like a listening system. It's a sensitive system that listens to certain phenomena, and you know, and kind of focuses attention on it, and like extracts it and gives you the experience of it. There is another thing that I was thinking about in terms of like sound and this installation, which is like, I was thinking a lot about, you know, the history of representation of movement, and there is like a lot of there is like a track of representation of movement in the visual world that ended up in cinema, say, you know, so you have moving image, and then I was thinking, okay, I mean, this is, and of course then you have like the line of Marais, for example, that like he tried to freeze the movement, and where you can see the history of the movement, and it's all very interesting, and I very interesting for me also. But I was thinking, like, in sound, like, there is like you know, is there like movement in sound, and how is it represented, and the idea of speed, say, like velocity, and in this respect I think like that I'm still thinking about it, but I think that the installation, my installation, is kind of two-folded. It's like it is the embodiment of movement and speed, and the representation of it at the same time. So and I think sound here comes because like sound, when you have like instruments and stuff, it's always about movement. Movement produces sound, so the speed, all the parameters of movement, they it produces sound. And in this respect, I could think further
on like relations of movement and sound and you know, is it too noisy?
Yeah, I'm just wondering if it's yeah, it comes in and out. Okay, I have maybe one last question.
And can you?
I'm like this, no?
Yeah, go the other way. That way. Yeah, it's better.
Okay. I always do that. I don't know why. It's like maybe something when I was really a baby.
So, so this project involved quite a lot of technology and sort of the process, also a lot of negotiations and with different organizations. But where was the most sort of crucial aspect in realizing this project that, you know, couldn't be compromised? What was the core part that brings all this when you were building this project?
Well, I mean, I could think of it now. I mean, there's like, if one element was missing, it would compromise the project. So there is, but there is like, it's a very kind of say, because you have a public element, you have the trams, the tram transport, that is something that is a system that is, you know, that we can only kind of you know, approach, but not really manipulate. So this is the very important. This is super important to have actually the data from the real, you know, tram movement, which in this case, like I would, I call it, it's like monitoring these few trams, like gives a small insight into the dynamics of the bloodstream of the city, or the, you know, or the dynamics of city as an organism, say. So this is very important. It's very important to have that in order, like on the conceptual level, definitely. So it was very important to actually be able to measure and transmit the speed. I guess this is, and then of course it was also very important to have the fans that could actually generate enough wind and enough stream so that we can actually really experience it like as a significant. That it is not like a marker, like, you know, like a small something, but it actually you really experience. This like for me, this is also very important to kind of, I have like a series of projects that are kind of insisting on creating a situation where the experience is the most important, where it's like where visitors in first person experience some kind of phenomenon, something happens. So it's not like that they're out of it and like observing it like as visual, but more like immersed in it. And this is like, I could also say that maybe I think like this because I come from music somehow, you know, my background is sound music, and it's always with sound, it always immerses you. You're never like distant to it. You're always in it. And this is for me kind of an important aspect, especially in the times of that we live now, where like there is like how you call it, mediating or like everything is being mediated like several times on the, you know, from its physical kind of core to when you get it, it's so many steps in between, which is good and enables a lot of things, but I kind of want to persist in the first person experience.
Okay. Thank you. another beer, another drink.